sti giorni quando vieni il bel sole. La 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 la. On days like these when skies are blue and fields are green.
So here we are, finally, after a year of waiting. We're in Italy, we're in Turin, and we're at the Italdesign. We've been personally invited to come here to road test their GTR50 prototype road car vehicle. Can't wait to get out in it. This is going to be absolutely amazing, and I hope you follow us all the way through. Let's get in the car, take it for a drive. So this is me just sending a few pictures to some pals, telling them what I'm doing. The million euro question: what does the GTR50 Italdesign drive like? So I'm just in the mountain region of Turin at the moment, sitting here in the 1-of-1 test car, which is absolutely mind-boggling. We're going to take it for a drive now so you can understand what the dynamics of the vehicle is. I need to watch out for pedestrians, old people, tourists and cyclists. So I've got three things to concentrate on. Crazy people in two CVs going by like the rally drivers, but here we have it. Wow. So you know what, this is something special for a hand-built car, which has come from a factory production model and then kind of chopped down into little bits and pieces and put back together. The Roadman is absolutely wonderful. And just listen to the engine noise. There isn't any. This I would liken to a samurai's steel-bladed sword. It's precise, it's lethal, but it's controlled as well. Absolutely wonderful. Sitting on the wrong side of the road, driving and sitting in the wrong seat for me. But it really, the car engages you, it wants you to drive it. But it feels sure-footed, very sensible. You can tell the gearbox has got the 2021 Nismo mapping in it. Very predictive. You can leave this car in drive. If you don't want to use the flaps, no problem. All we do with this one is put it in drive. The vehicle uses all of its your senses, G senses, everything senses, and it predicts the road for you. So if you're going into a sweeping bend, mid bend, it'll automatically drop down a gear. So then you can actually come out of that bend with full control, both hands on the wheels, with plenty of traction there to give. So it's retained that GTR driver's dynamics, which has made the car such a hit literally since the 60s, because let's not forget the heritage of this car. 1969, Nissan launched the GTR with an S20 engine. So here we are, 2022 now. The penultimate build for this GTR platform is this Italdesign 50. And I can't think of any better place but to give it a drive than the mountains of Turin, just outside the factory, for Italdesign. Absolutely wonderful. So here we are, for those that don't know, we're at the top of Turin with the GTR50, and I'm just going to give you a little bit of background and the history of this car and where it came from. So I'm going to take you back to the Geneva Motor Show, Switzerland, back in 2017-2018. At the show there was Nissan displaying their GTR and the normal brands, and also there was a company called Italdesign. So the two leading product directors got together and came up with this concept of, it's 50 years celebration of GTR, let's have a collaboration, let's get together
and make 50 one-of-one hand-spoke vehicles. Now, Italdesign is a very old hand-built bespoke design company in Italy that have been doing one-offs for decades. Move it together with cutting-edge Japanese technology, and this is what we've got. Absolutely beautiful car. Aerodynamics are fabulous on it. It's bristling with carbon fiber. The vehicle itself is actually based on 1974 C110 race car. If you can flick through Yahoo or Google or any other charge engine, you'll actually see that the front end of this car, which is what made it such an internet break, is based on the front end of their C110 race car, and they've carried it through. At the back of the vehicle, we've got the traditional twin loop brake lights, which goes with GTR since the 1960s. So, what makes this car unique? What makes this car of one of one? Italdesign are all about the detail. So, for the customer, this car is unique to them. We use the Nissan GTR heritage. So, what they've asked for is every car is different, and it's based on a unique car from Nissan's racing heritage. This is number 20. So number 20 was a historical race car by the Nismo factory that was pioneered through a lot of racing seasons. The color's unique. The owner, the new owner, has the opportunity to specify to the shed what color they want to use, and then that color is copyrighted and the owner can name the color, and it can never ever be repeated ever again. The same again when we move on to the interior. The 1 million euro is merely the starting price, and the sky's the limit to go with it. So, sitting inside the GTR50, now this version, I mean, as I've said, it's the test car, so the quality and the fitment is nowhere near what the Italdesign final fitment will be. But one thing you can be assured of is the interior will be totally bespoke. There'll be carbon, there'll be leather, there'll be Alcantara, hand-prepared, hand-stitched to the customer's specification. This is a test car, so you can see that we've got these stickers all over it. And just in case you're wondering, this red button isn't an ejector seat button, nor is it the alpha race button. This is a battery kill button, so when the test driver's out doing the rounds of a circuit, if there's any immediate failure, what we do, bang, we just hit that, kills everything all dead, and then the car comes to a slow, safe halt. So here we are to the iconic back end, which everybody knows of and every GTR dreams of being. So the iconic rear lights on the back. Now this design was made by Italdesign, and it's a patented design, groundbreaking and totally unique. You can actually see where you can put your hands through the lights, and these light up and just look absolutely fabulous. You've got this amazing rear wing on the back, which again was a totally unique one-off design. Every GTR has always come with a rear spoiler, but this one really just finishes the whole thing off. The back end as well, also the aerodynamics, vent all the hot air out from the transmission and the exhaust systems along there. And that kind of brings this video to an end. So I just want to say to Italdesign and everybody there, thank you ever so much for allowing me and Digi, our amazing camera guy, to come in today to make this video. And you know what I'm going to say to you now? If you like the content and you've enjoyed the film, give it a like, give it a subscribe. The details are along the bottom of the screen now. I'm not going to confuse you to tell you what we've got coming next, because we've got lots of great footage involved. Just follow us along with our journey through this year, and we're going to show you some amazing stuff. Once again, signing off. Ciao, Bella. Thank you.